That leaves the tornado warning in effect.
Kansas is a destination state for storm hunting, and spring is the prime season. Officially, Kansas ranks second only behind Texas as having the most tornadoes, but when land area of the two states is considered, they are about equal. Kansas' heartland geography places it where warm, moist Gulf air collides with cold fronts to generate powerful thunderstorms known as supercells. These are the energy centers that spin up large and violent tornadoes. And while potentially catastrophic, the fascination with these storms puts many photographers and storm enthusiasts, even out-of-state hunters, on the road when conditions are right. Storm hunting can be dangerous and is not recommended without expert weather knowledge, communications, and even live Doppler radar in a vehicle. And the truth is, chasing supercells often yields no sightings of funnels or tornadoes. Rain or darkness often hides the twisters, and being out of position by only a few miles can make the difference in seeing a tornado that may last only a few minutes. Rotation and wall cloud sightings aren't uncommon, but they are not guaranteed to actually spin up a twister. When a tornado forms, it's a matter of light, timing, and position to get a good one on film. Honestly, storm chasing is a low percentage proposition. I rarely get to photograph these climax events, but this weekend, while traveling Highway 42 in Kingman County, I ran head-on into a storm cell where I saw five tornadoes. These were relatively small, with funnels that had a mouse tail look and actually showed clear air between the hanging funnel and the ground swirl. Several times, two tornadoes were on the ground within a few miles of each other. These lasted only a minute or two each time they dropped from the clouds. I had to skirt the oncoming twisters for safety's sake, and I was soon around and behind them on the safe side. That made filming less risky. By then, the F0 and F1 storms had intensified, and I guess the largest tornado I saw at about EF2 on an EF5 scale. It stayed on the ground for at least 10 minutes with limited damage to the Spivey Wind Farm and several residences near Harper. In a state like ours, no one diminishes these deadly and catastrophic storms. Yet, they still hold a fascination as they skip across the prairie. If only there were a way to see them without experiencing their dreadful effects. Even so, they are an annual part of natural Kansas. I'm Mike Blair for Kansas Wildlife, Parks, and Tourism.